Hello, welcome back to Tunguska. We just did a lot of work off camera, meaning we went and got a double barrel shotgun and also got the thing from the Sido village. I think it was, you know, his house has a little balcony and that's where you can get extra ammo. So you get the extra 9mm rounds, you also get the full metal jackets from over there. And the son of double shotgun is from this map actually. It's from over here. So this is the church. I like the new maps, they are great. And over here is the generator room, and in the generator room you find the shotgun, the sound of shotgun, and then you can probably activate the sprinklers. Let me check if I can do this quest first. Remember, you need 5 gasoline, which I have. You only have 4 gasoline in the cemetery. It's so easy to play with the map, also a lot more, I don't know, interesting. Gives the game a totally new look. I think this is almost ready. Let me check something else over there. Oh, I forgot we can get potatoes. Do you not know how to harvest potatoes? That's annoying. I guess this is a very good way to get some survival experience, harvest potatoes. They're actually more than I remember, but I guess they don't mind. It's only a few potatoes. Also have to turn on the sprinkler system if I remember correctly. Look at our survival experience. It's growing so big. Okay, that's perfect. We have made agriculture. Oh, that's a lot of interesting stuff. The interview, Sidor, potato farm. So this is one of the places where you cannot really be gray. You have to choose a side, and usually that side will be to kill these guys. I guess in a way that they are disrupting everything. So that's another new story. If you give all of the new stories, you'll probably make about 2000 rubles in the beginning of the game, I don't know. So that should be enough for us to get some armor and some other stuff. My energy is a little buggy, I feel like it. If I remember correctly. Can enter this little part, which I don't think it will help us. Now also remember, this is the dock, and in the dock you'll find the Kevlar helmet. Don't get too close to the graves, it will spawn ghouls. And I tested out, if you kill the ghouls with the crowbar or a melee weapon, you get more rewards, but you also get hit and get the syndrome thingy. So oh, why is it zero health? I guess we can pretend to eat a little bread. Yeah, okay, let's be full HP, full everything, because we're going underground, and underground there will be ghouls. They're actually not ghouls, they're the... what were they called? The bladed ones? The skites. Thank you. There's something very bug with the game and I cannot put my finger on it. I'm pressing right click to attack and it doesn't work. I don't understand it. That's super annoying. So what is happening? Well, I guess I'll find out next time. For now, we just have to kill the ghouls. I guess it's because I'm running, but it shouldn't cause you to stop aiming. Okay, these guys are much harder to kill than I remember them. That was... how many shots? I don't know how many, but it was a decent number. You can also completely avoid them and just go up here, but I like to get experience for killing them as well. That scared me, because this thing can kill you. I think this is where we get our first AK. No, they changed it, Rad. The developer changed that, so you don't get the AK-47 or the AK-74. Superior potato, why is it superior? Does it wear a cape? Does it have a twirly mustache? Why is it superior? So you no longer get the AK-47, you get a scorpion. Very interesting. Well, I guess the AK was too powerful to find it over here. There's nothing in this room. Okay, so I have the priest journal. And this is the safe of the priest. You can open it if you get the key from the priest, which is in the mad mechanic. I don't worry, we'll go there probably after this phase. What? This is a bit annoying. What is this creature doing? I got stuck there a little bit. Okay, let's get out of here. I didn't get the AK-47 that I used to kill the bandit super fast. Bread and alcohol. What about just cooking the potato? Oh yeah, I forgot about that. That just turns off the lights. So sounds very creepy the first time you hear it, yes? But it doesn't do anything as sinister as you think. Well, I suppose I could just eat something over here, sleep until morning. And then get to work on the farm in the morning. Oh, everything is so creepy. Is my battery holding? Yes. Yeah, I guess this is one of the strong points of the game. It's very creepy. Sorry I'm not speaking too much. I'm trying to focus on the game itself because it's not an easy one. Can I put some skills into something that will make me better at something now? I don't want SMGs, but oh, I can see now. They kind of force you to choose something in the beginning, but you cannot choose very well. Faster fire, right? I want rifles, but rifles seems like it will be a big problem. Against doors, crates and ghouls. You can destroy crates with kicks. Well, now we know. So really, I have to choose something. I really want to choose something, but I don't know what. So I'll not choose anything. Fitness is also pretty good. Let's skin is the one that I look at. No, I guess... it'll have to be stealth, to be honest. Shotgun is pretty good, but I guess SMG will have to be better at some point. No, we'll kill them without anything. These guys, they don't mess around. So I guess I don't have to kill everyone. So did the, what did he give me? Nothing, probably. Nothing interesting. Yeah, the game has changed a lot. I feel like I'm taking more damage and the enemies are dealing. Not a chance to reach them. Okay, let's go back and sleep a little more and then we'll come back and kill them. If you remember how the game was in the beginning, you could even kill those guys with a shotgun because you would go very close to them and shoot them at point blank and they couldn't really react. But now they react so much better. Well, I guess the... some birds are stuck in the church. Nothing unusual over there. What are the crates that you can destroy? Not those, probably. Okay, that was not so bad. I mean, we did a accomplish your objective somehow. How much HP do we have? 110. Okay, that's a lot of HP. Sorry, Ghoul, not today. You know what? No, not today. Not enough ammo for today. I guess the game is a lot harder than I remember it because of all of these mechanics that are working better now, or as intended. Let him kill him. I'll respawn and I'll come back over here. I didn't calculate my moves right. I know there was a guard on that side, but I just went in blind. Because it's not just about killing someone, it's also about having enough HP to survive. Well, I guess I can go and get Razor's armor if I really... Oh, actually, I cannot go. I guess sneaking is the most important skill after all, especially in the beginning when you don't even have armor. It was me, a dirty rat. It's kind of annoying because you don't really have time to react sometimes. And the damage is so big. Yeah, this really feels like Iron Man. Yeah, it's a shotgun, by the way. I don't even have a melee weapon. Yes, yes, it's good to have infinite ammo. Crouching is very dangerous, from what I can see. Come on, this is so... this is the most annoying thing I've seen in the game so far. If you crouch, you cannot run. If you... What's the point of crouching then? You cannot get fast... I don't know, so if you're like this, if you... Let's say if you are crouching, you have to press... Shift to run, right? But you can also press crouch and kind of lock yourself... I mean, if you press C again, you lock yourself out of the running animation, so... It's a little tricky. I'll admit it's a little tricky to pull it off. I don't like it. Some commands shouldn't override each other like that because it makes it so much harder to play. Again, it's probably because of the new skill system. Probably the gun damage is a little lower. And I lost 50 HP with that. What do you mean doesn't have anything? You were shooting a pistol. Oh, he's just the shotgun guy. A shotgun shell and a dream.
Держу! Граната!
Эх! I don't understand where the bullets are going.
Валяй, кореш, я его прижал!
I think I've killed one, maybe one. Anyway, this is. A bit angry that that guy didn't have any guns or ammo. They don't even drop their guns anymore? That is very strange. So how are you supposed to kill them if you don't have the ammo to do it? Anyway, this is pretty fun. I admit it has a few problems here and there, and I'm a bit upset that they can basically just hide their weapons after you kill them.
Мужик!
That guy should have been the last one, maybe. Maybe not. But I guess I just like the reloading sound because it makes me feel strong, but it's not. It's not helping. Oh, this would have been so easy to flank, okay. Ouch. The last bullet, the last man, the last everything. Let's give that another go. I like it. It's so much more tense than I remember it. Come on, the last guy with the last bullet, the last everything. I guess you have to play more strategically, more tactical, I mean. Don't waste bullets, don't run around too much, don't take too much damage. The first kill you get for free, basically. So it's no longer that shoot until you hit something. Okay, apparently the damage is much harder than I thought. I wanted to die over there because I already lost so much health. I guess you really have to buy the armor before you engage into any combat. Yeah, I guess our options are pretty hardcore. Some people said they like this difficulty a lot more because it's not, no one is a bullet sponge anymore, but still... it's annoying. And that's what I call a lot of good luck and some tactical awareness. okay, easy. Let's sneak up on the last guy. Okay, that was not as good as I thought. Some of them are still bullet sponges. Okay, so that's the last guy. Okay, that should be all of them. Look, it even says the button has been cleared. Whew. Wait, what? We leave nothing behind. Now, because I know my luck and I know that once I went back home and I got stuck into a storm and I died. Actually, we're not safe. Okay, let's just go home. So the sprinklers are on and we are on our way back home. Yeah, some people might like the tactical look more, I don't know. It was a very tough fight and I barely got anything out of it. I think I lost more because I lost so much food healing up. But I guess food is not so expensive and besides, we can always get more money by reporting our stories. I have to say, that was not half bad. Even though it took a while until I got used to their AI a little bit. Yeah, but I had to flank, I had to... I don't know, I had to do a lot of things to just win the fight. ₽66. I need the sewer key, don't you dare sell the sewer key, we need it to go and get the chest, the content of the chest. I'm not sure if I can cook the potato anymore, so let's just sell some of them. Well, I don't need the key anymore, but he doesn't want to buy it either. The hearts are worth quite a bit. The talons are worth quite a bit as well. Who'd have thought? Now, I need more bullets because I'm going to fight some soldiers, which will be very, very sad for me. Oh, that's so expensive. Wow, ammo is dirt expensive. So basically, nothing is dirt cheap, but everything is super expensive. It's almost a luxury. No. Potato farm. Yeah, so he gave us what? Oh, the hunting shotgun and more bullets. Oh, but I already did that, so I already do the mission beforehand. Repair the AKM using the mad mechanic. Why do I have some pistols with me? I don't know. I guess that's to train. Oh yeah, that's to train. I don't need more training, I know how to do it. Just throw away the AK. Well, oh yeah, I forgot. So, the wolf. That wolf is stuck in the bushes. I guess we shouldn't have seen that. Let's go and see what the wolf dropped. Come on, they don't drop their items anymore, that's so annoying. I guess he was bleeding out. I guess we'll not report the stories right now because we don't need them. So I guess to get to the other side... we'll have to use, yeah, we have to sell the sawn-off shotgun. Definitely the sawn-off shotgun will be the problem. Yeah, a fair price indeed. I guess it was not so bad, so we'll probably have to do something like this. So we can kill the soldiers using the assault rifle, and then we can probably use the hunting. Okay, I'll have to go back to my base and, you know, clear up my inventory a little bit, dream, sleep a little bit. Let's put a serum over there. Maybe I'll need the journal. I'll take it with me, maybe. But I'm a bit limited, I feel like it, because of the lower inventory. I know this is for a quest, but I keep forgetting what quest. Can we just not... okay, that's better. Five potatoes, low heat. I'm not sure about this recipe system. I don't want to memorize stuff. What about this? Yeah, let's put it in the inventory. Or is it worth a lot of money? Dr. Bootlegger. I don't remember where I got this or what am I supposed to do with it. I'll just sell it, I don't care. Probably I'll care later and regret it. Okay, so we're filling our inventory with nice stuff. Well, except for this is not nice. And I guess we can sell all of it if we really need more money. And yeah, this is a good game. How expensive is food? Because that's another important question. That's pretty expensive, I don't like it at all. Probably I'll need a bandage as well. Potatoes, I don't want to get them back. I used up all of my food. Well, I guess it's more or less fair. Let me see if I can cook the potatoes. Maybe I was not really understanding how the cooking works. Oh, I guess it works very easy. What do you mean some fuel? Okay, apparently we have a lot of things to do. See you next time, bye.